You're the DJ? I thought you were deaf. When I was younger, I really wanted to become a DJ. Because I love music, that idea was a barrier to me because there are so many DJs that are not deaf. All DJs are hearing, so I felt hopeless about that particular goal. When I saw there were these deaf DJs in New York and in DC, I realized if they can do it, I can too. I started DJing in 2015, and I bought a very, very small turntable kit that I could hook up to my iPad. But I just kept practicing. In my third year at UMass Dartmouth, my roommate and I decided to host a party in our apartment. And that's really when I started mixing. And I would just keep playing until the RA would shut down the party. And all the hearing people in the room would say, "Well, who's that DJ?" And I'd say, "Yo, it's me right over here." And people would say, "Wait, hold up. You're the DJ? I thought you were deaf. How are you doing this?" I really want to inspire and influence hearing people to let them know that anybody, like me, can be whoever they want to be. I grew up hard of hearing, audiologically. The only hard of hearing person in my family. A lot of people spoke or used speech around me, which I could not access, I could not understand. And it wasn't until I went to the Horace Mann School for the Deaf in Boston, and when I worked with and met deaf teachers, deaf friends, deaf peers, then I got exposed to deaf culture. I had access to information, I had access to everything. That's when I started to figure out what kind of person I wanted to be because of that environment. So when I'm working, the music is playing, the music is thumping, my hearing aids are off. Having a laptop, there is a feature called matching speed. It allows me to be able to synchronize or match the beats synchronization of one song toward another song so I can actually look and compare which song is a little bit faster than the other one, and I can see the tempo of the song. And there's a numerical assignment to each tempo of each song, and I can see the transitions visually, so I don't have to put on the headphones to listen to and find out that synchronization like the DJs used to do in old school. Transition is so important when you're going from one song to the next song. It's got to be smooth. And then I watch people. I gotta read the crowd. I just want to make sure I'm doing my job. Now, apart from music, when I take my hearing aids off, I can't hear the phone ring sometimes. I can't hear the TV. I can't hear a conversation on the peripheral. I'm like profoundly deaf at that point without my hearing aids. All these other labels of clinical deaf, lowercase d deaf, hard of hearing, hearing impaired, person with hearing loss, none of those things mean anything to me. And some people don't know what to do with that. They actually kind of walk away, they get nervous, they have anxiety. I said, tell people, look, just relax. And you don't have to be over the top with it, just speak to me normally. Let me look at your face, read your face. Just relax, it'll be fine. That's what comes to mind when I talk about experiences of sound.